Hi, I'm Sjouke Bootsma. I'm currently Director for Supply Chain Management at Tedet. I started with Tedet some 13 and a half years ago. First, I was responsible for the asset management department in the Netherlands. Then I became responsible for the large projects department in the Netherlands. And since 2 years, I've become director for the supply chain for the whole of Tedet. Well, there are a lot of quality systems like ISO 9000 or 9001. I think almost everybody knows them. But if you look at companies like Tenet, where we manage a lot of assets and where we build assets, I think the ISO 55000 fits better to our processes and also our assets. The other aspect was also an external reason. The regulator in the Netherlands demanded Tenet to have a quality system that fits to our primary task. So that was the reason, the second reason why we implemented this. The third reason was that it is, of course, of the most, it's very important that we stay in control of our assets and our processes alike. Indeed, power transformers are very, very important. If they fail, everything, the whole system can fail. And since they are, I think, our most primary components, it's really important that they are reliable, that they perform like we want them to perform. So it's always better to prevent these failures. And I think, let's say, condition monitoring and other techniques will help us here. And I also think a very, very important fundament is your data management. Do you have all the data at hand? Is your data reliable? And if you don't have that, I think it will become a real challenge to implement the ISO 55000. So data management, and data management. Yeah, focus on the power transformers. I think the first thing is the aging of the equipment. A lot of equipment was installed 10, 20 or 30 years ago. That's one aspect we have to take into account. On the other side, we also have to take into account that since the in-feed of renewable energies increases, also the use of our assets has to become more dynamic. That's also important. First of all, I think the outcome of your inspections and condition monitoring can become more transparent. That's the first thing. Also more fact-based, although the experience of your working people still is very important. This more objective approach will help us also to have, let's say, a more predictable performance of our assets, not only now, but also in the near future. So we can also, by analyzing, define the best, let's say, the most effective and efficient countermeasures to prevent our assets from failing. Well, the most important assets, it depends on where you look at. For, let's say, the more conventional AC grid, of course, transformers. Therefore, we need to focus on this life cycle management. And it's not only about, let's say, having the tools, but also having it embedded in a well-functioning quality system like ISO 55000.